You said, right? So for ilium, to check for anterior glide, what you do is stand on the side of the patient. You're going to use a heel contact, right? You're going to make contact with the psoas on both sides. If I push, the PSI is anteriorly, right? I'm assessing for anterior glide. So what you do is you contact, you preload, and then you spring the joint this direction, right? So you're pushing P to A, but technically you're also, your line of drive has some medial to lateral along with it, right? So I'm making a bilateral contact, but don't push at the same time. So challenge through one hand first, and then challenge through the opposite hand. This is checking for anterior glide of the ilium. For posterior glide, you would make your contact within the sacroiliac joint on the opposite side from where you're standing. So what you do is you do iliac crest, windshield wiper down until you find the PSIS. Remove your superior hand fingers, place it directly within the sacroiliac joint. Ask for permission to go to the front and grab the ASIS. Then bring that ASIS back, so you're trying to create posterior rotation of the ilium, right? If you feel rotation of the ilium, if you feel a little bit of motion at the tip of your fingers, kind of ilium gliding on, at the tip of your fingers, or feeling sacral base falling from your fingers, that means you're good. You have posterior gliding of the ilium. If not, then you have a PGR, posterior glide restriction. If you have a PGR or a posterior glide restriction, that means the ilium is stuck AS, right? The PSIS is stuck anterior superior. To adjust it, we would contact the ischial tuberosity to bring it back to neutral. But if you had an AGR, anterior glide restriction, that means the ilium is stuck PI, posterior inferior. To adjust it, you would contact the PSIS and push it P to A. That was a quick review of ilium, AGR, PGR.